Pack your things.
I'm not alone, it's my job.
Fired!
Welcome back to Brothers Theory Productions, everyone. I am Q, and today we have another Henry Stickmin theory. You might envision Henry as the main character and the hero of the Henry Stickmin series, but I believe that Dave deserves some time in the spotlight.
Oh, thank you.
Let's begin, shall we? Dave Panpa is a minor character in the series, a man who is eager to do the best job he possibly can. But he's evidently not very hardworking or lucky. He always gets fired because he can be very negligent when he doesn't care about accomplishing something enough. Or he can be clumsy. Although he's eager to do a great job, he often falls short. Although his importance to the story is rather minor,
yes, very minor,
he always seems to help Henry whenever he can. Don't believe me? I'll show you. In Breaking the Bank, Dave only appears in the credits of the Legacy version, where he is the police officer who pushes Henry into the cell after his arrest. He's evil, right? Yes, in this scene he's clearly evil. However, this scene, along with the entire credit sequence, was removed in the remastered version of the game. Puffballs United did this to avoid continuity errors throughout the series. This decision makes these scenes and his actions not canon. All Dave's actions are invalid and don't exist anymore. Moreover, Dave doesn't have a role in Breaking the Bank. So let's move on to... Dave was newly hired as a police officer at the West Mesa Penitentiary. He was eager to do his best job while on the force. He was partnered up with Rupert Price, another officer at the penitentiary. Dave went upstairs with Rupert to Henry's cell to give him the package. Rupert, standing next to Dave, told Henry he was
free to go.
After Henry became excited, Rupert laughed and said,
"Not really, but you've got a package."
Rupert kicked the package into Henry's cell, and he told Henry not to get his hopes up because Dave already checked it for anything he could use, although Dave never even bothered to open it. That's when Dave realized that he did not do what he was supposed to, and now it was too late. So he said that of course he checked the package, otherwise he would...
It's my job, not alone, it's my job.
After Henry's escape from West Mesa, Dave was fired from his duties for negligence. Although Dave's actions costed his job at the prison, he successfully freed Henry, like he always planned. Dave isn't clumsy. He's a genius, like Jack Sparrow. He acts like a buffoon around others to get an advantage over them.
You are without doubt the worst pirate I've ever heard of.
Dave is a man with a plan. Giving Henry the box was part of his plan to save Henry.
That's got to be the best pirate I've ever seen.
So it would seem.
Dave realized that he needs a new job, so he eventually decided to work as a security guard for the town museum. When Dave was hired, he was then partnered up with Kurtz, a man who already hated his dead-end job at the museum. But it started to get worse for him, as he found this Dave to be really annoying. Dave and Kurtz's job was to guard the World War II section of the museum, and having to do with Dave was very unfortunate for Kurtz. Henry sees the two guards taking part in this awkward situation. Dave was in the middle of the part of the story where he was fired.
And then I got fired.
Kurt had it by this point and told Dave to shut up.
Please shut up.
If Henry decides to throw the model of a World War II biplane, it directly hits Kurt in the head, knocking him out. Clumsy Dave immediately runs away. Henry passes both guards and continues his mission to steal the Tunisian diamonds. Again, Dave is not clumsy. He's a genius. He has to act like he doesn't know what he's doing and he just bumps against a pillar. He cannot team up with Henry, because that would be very suspicious. He just makes sure that everyone thinks that Henry overpowered him and knocked him unconscious. If the other guards knew about their collab, they would threaten Dave to get the location of Henry out of him. Dave is being smart by, quote-unquote, accidentally running against that pillar. In infiltrating the airship, Dave somehow got captured by the Topat clan. They then took him into the airship and locked him into a cell next to the vault area. The key that opens his cell was left next to the Topat computer. Henry has the option to pick it up. If Henry never frees Dave, then uses the power glove, Dave will laugh at him before the failure screen shows up. However, if Henry does save Dave, the free man will thank you and try to escape. When Henry finds the ruby in the vault, Dave can be seen crawling through a vent. A USB has presented itself. If you choose to take the USB and decide to put it in the computer at the CCC, a secret code will be granted. 1214. When going through the top, you can enter this code and a door will open. Henry goes in the door and finds a chest with a Legend of Zelda inspired sword inside. Although this sword doesn't do much, Dave probably thought that it could have helped Henry escape. I told you he wasn't an idiot. Since Dave is completely absent in fleeing the complex, we'll move on to completing the mission. In Topat Civil Warfare, Dave is a semi-major character. The poor dude is still locked up in his cell. When Henry's leadership is denounced for abandoning Ellie Rose in the wall, Jeffrey Plump and Thomas Chestershire are locked up in the brig along with our boy Dave. Once Henry makes his way to the brig, he asks Dave to help him free the others by taking out Floyd Winters. Dave then reluctantly joins Henry's faction of the Topat clan, as they flee the airship in an escape pod.
Quick everyone, get into this escape pod.
Dave also appears in the secret ending, Multiverse Correction. After Henry's arrest, a mysterious interdimensional package appeared out of nowhere at the prison. Dave found the box and told Rupert it was for Henry.
I got a package here for someone named Henry. I love delivering packages.
Dave's job was to check the package for anything useful. Unfortunately, Dave completely neglected that job again and did not check the box. So whatever was in that box was going to Henry, no matter what. As you can see, Dave blindly supports Henry with his deeds. Although he didn't know what Henry had done to Ellie, Dave couldn't have known since he was still locked up in the cell when Ellie explained everything to the Topats in the cockpits. He also delivers the package to Henry, without questioning the sudden appearance of said box. This deed supports the fact that he actively wants to free Henry. Without Dave, Henry wouldn't have been free, and he wouldn't have stopped the Topat clan. Some people see Dave as a buffoon and an idiot.
You think I'm an idiot?
But he's actually brilliant. Whatever his actions may suggest at first, he always helps Henry whenever he can.
A hero. I just couldn't see it.
Dave is a true hero.
A watchful protector. A dark knight.
Or this theory is completely wrong and dumb. Oh well.